Okay, everybody, and welcome back to Learn with Minecraft Education. We're going to be looking today at how to download and install texture packs. If this is what you were looking for today, make sure you like and subscribe to see more videos like this. Now, first things first, we're going to look for MCPEDL in our favorite search engine, and this is where we go to find textures and shaders and skins and things like that. Now, a texture pack is going to replace a lot of the textures that come with Minecraft if we want to make our worlds look a little bit different from the regular version. I recommend just going through these, clicking on any that you like the look of, and trying to find the MPack file once you've clicked on it. Now, I will show you some that I recommend now, and there will be a video at the end of this comparing different footage from different texture packs. We're going to look at one, first of all, called Dragon Dance, just to show you how to get these onto your computer, okay? So, search for Dragon Dance, we're going to click on that top result there, we're going to scroll down, and we're going to try and find the MPack file, and when we click on that, it's going to open up Minecraft Education and import that file for us, okay? Now, the next one we're going to take a look at is called Modern HD. Probably my favorite texture pack, makes everything look kind of crisp and clean, without going too over the top. And again, we're going to look for the MPack file, and get that imported into Minecraft Education. Now, the third and final one I want to get installed on here before we move on is John Smith Legacy Edition. And for that one, you need to go to his website, johnsmithlegacy.co.uk, and I'll put all the links in the description. What you do is you scroll down to the Bedrock edition of the texture pack and find the oldest version that is there. I know that that is compatible with Minecraft Education Edition. Okay, so the one furthest down on the list, those Bedrock ones. Right, so now we're going to go across over to Minecraft and we're going to see if we can get those loaded in. Okay, so now we're over in the game. We're going to start a new world or load up one of the worlds that we already have. Go to Settings, go to Resource Packs, and then we're going to look down through all of our shaders and texture packs, and we're just going to click on the ones that we want and activate them, all right? And we must, of course, get rid of, deactivate any ones that we don't want. Now, once you've selected those and activated them, you just need to click play, and it will load up your world with those textures on there. Don't forget, you can have more than one active at once, so if you want to see how it looks with different shaders and different texture packs combined, then you can do that too. But you may just be wanting to create a world for your students that has a certain feel to it, so a medieval feel or a Japanese feel or a cartoon feel, and that's where the texture packs are super helpful. Now, I am going to go through 7 of my favorite texture packs now so that you can kind of compare these and decide which ones you want to take a look at. All of the links for these will be in the description, so you can just click on them. And we're going to start with Dragon Dance. All right, so as you can see, this one here is kind of a cel-shaded cartoony style, but it's got a kind of a high resolution look to it, and it runs very smoothly. So certainly if you're after a kind of cel-shaded cartoon style, this would be the one for you. Okay, the next one is called Yamoto, and it gives everything a kind of Japanese style to your world. And you can see the hotbar at the bottom there looks pretty cool, with the kind of scroll of paper and the red circle around it. And the trees have changed a lot as well. They've kind of got this, they've all changed from kind of green to yellow. And yeah, if you're creating a world and you want that kind of Japanese architecture feel to it, it looks awesome. Okay, next here we've got the John Smith Legacy. It's a pretty cool one, this one. It's the textures are like super high res, and they're kind of, almost for some people, I guess they could be a little bit too much. It makes everything look like kind of Skyrim in Minecraft. The biggest difference for me is probably the NPCs. Their faces look so different compared to regular Minecraft. But I think it's got a good look to it. I do use this one sometime, and I think the hotbar looks pretty cool as well at the bottom. All right, Modern HD, this is the one I use most of the time, just for regular use. I think it's got a good mixture of kind of realism and still looking like a game. A lot of the textures look really sharp, really crisp, but without kind of distracting you from the fact that you're still playing Minecraft. It still feels like Minecraft, which is nice. Yeah, this is my favorite one. Right, next we've got Veristicraft. This one's a very clear looking texture pack, very high res. They've gone for a bit more of a photorealistic look on this one. So if you're a fan of this, it is a good texture pack. For me, it kind of detracts from Minecraft a little bit. I kind of don't feel like I'm playing Minecraft. Everything's a bit too realistic. But it's a good one. It runs nice and smoothly. Next is Ovo's Rustic Redemption. It's got this kind of medieval look to it. But unlike a few of the others, it achieves it without changing everything too much. So the textures have changed, but they don't look too different from the Minecraft textures. So that's a good one. And finally, we've got Summerfield's Ocean. It's a nice texture pack that changes the way a lot of the tools look, particularly. I'm not a massive fan of the hotbar on this one, but yeah, it's good. It's just personal taste. So it takes us to the end of the video. Please remember that all the links are in the description, and if you found today's video helpful, please do subscribe to my channel to see more content, and I will see you all next time.